Hey, I would like to introduce some bounties we have introduced at DF for breaking the RSA assumptions and testing that they hold. So let's go back to the Veselovsky proof. We've already seen it a couple of times today. So it's a proof of exponentiation. We want to prove that y is equals x to the power of e modulo some RSA modulus m. And we do that in the interactive version of the protocol by the prover sending y. The verifier sends a challenge in the form of a prime p. And then the prover computes the proof pi, which is x to the e divided by p, the quotient, rounded down, modulo m. And then in the end, the verifier checks that pi to the p times x to the power of e mod p is equal to y. And so the correctness of this proof is relatively easy to check. So it's basically just a very simple statement that e is equal to the quotient times p plus the remainder. But for the soundness, we need to ask the question, how could a prover generate an invalid proof? So let's say the prover chooses some y tilde. That's not necessarily the right answer to our exponentiation problem. Then in order to generate a proof for this, they need to take this p-th root of y divided by x to the power of e mod p, which you can rewrite as y divided by x to the power of e to the power of 1 over p times something. So, but basically, what you can see is that the prover can basically choose any element, and if they are able to take a p-th root for some p that the verifier sends them afterwards, then they would be able to generate a proof for this y tilde, despite that not being the correct answer. And so we call this the adaptive root problem. And yeah, let's rewrite it as what is the adaptive root problem. The adversary chooses an x. A p is taken from primes to lambda, and they have to output a y so that y to the power of p equals x. So where does this adaptive root assumption fit into the already known RSA assumptions? So it's a bit different from all the RSA, strong RSA, and so on assumptions. So it implies the low order assumption, which is the one that the Pierczak construction is based on. Yeah, there you can see like we're getting a more extensive zoo of RSA assumptions now. And obviously, the adaptive root assumption also seems a bit exposed there because it's not implied by any of the others. The others are all a bit more like, oh yeah, there are some relations between them. And so we decided that we should start giving this a bit more scrutiny. So already a couple of months ago, we started a bounty program on this. There's now a $10,000 bounty for either finding an algorithm that solves the adaptive root problem in an RSA group faster than the fastest algorithm known for factoring, which would be GNFS. So it has to be asymptotically faster. Or alternatively, if you can reduce the adaptive root assumption to the strong RSA assumption, Diffie-Hellman assumption, or prove that the adaptive root assumption is non-equivalent to factoring in the generic ring model. Then we have a $3,000 bounty for either the most interesting, well, I mean, this one is definitely going to be about it, the most interesting paper that's published on the adaptive root assumption that's in 2020, or any other unknown reductions between between those assumptions that I've shown earlier. And we're also giving out 5 prizes on any high quality papers on the low order assumption and the adaptive root assumption in 2020. And these are some new bounties that I'll introduce today. Actually, the smart contract for those is unfortunately not deployed yet, but I hope I will be able to do that later today or tomorrow. There will be some bounties that you can redeem on the Ethereum blockchain by proving that you have a solution to the adaptive root problem. You can win up to 16 Ether if you can solve that for 2048-bit modulus. But if your algorithm isn't quite that good yet, then you can also try one of the lower moduli.
Wait, if you solve all of them, you get the sum of them?
If you solve all of them, you would get the sum of them, that's right.
More than 16.
You can get up to 29 Ether, that's right. Yeah. Yes, so please have a look at rsa.cash. There's a summary of all those bounties. Thank you.
Any questions?
So,
yep.
So in this problem,
hold on.
So if I understood it correctly, I get some element, then I can choose a P?
No.
No.
No, so you have to pick an element, and then you're given a P, and now you have to take the P-th root.
So why is it I'm given how P is randomly sampled?
Yes, so in the non-interactive model, it would be hash to prime, so it would be a hash function that outputs a prime.
So why is it adaptive root? Adaptive root sounded to me that the adversary can choose which root he wants to output. Well, why is it called adaptive root assumption? Sorry for the basic question.
So I think it's because the adversary has to adapt to the root that's picked, but maybe whoever picked this term can comment on this. That's my assumption.
Thanks.
It's the adaptive root assumption.